I started making YouTube videos to improve everyone's health and well-being through the idea that nutrient-dense animal foods contained key vitamins and minerals that are vital for optimal human health and development. When I discovered this years ago, I literally said to myself, if I do one thing before I leave this planet, it will be to improve the health of it through nutrition. If people are healthy, if people are happy, physically and mentally, the world will be in a better state. I see people on the street, my father, my disabled sister. I see how unhappy and how people aren't functioning how humans are meant to be, and it really hurts me inside. It's part of why I'm so pessimistic. But in order to achieve that goal, I figured that I needed to make as much money as possible, get as famous as possible, and become as influential as possible. That's why I do things like acting, bartending, try to network with people, and make YouTube videos. I feel like all of these things are conducive to my end goal. The reason I'm bringing this up is because all of these anti-vegan videos I make and these topics outside of the carnivore diet might not make sense. A lot of you guys say, Frank, why not just focus on the carnivore diet? I didn't make my YouTube channel originally on the carnivore diet. I just started marketing towards the carnivore diet because it made sense. You know, 2.5-3 years ago when I started my YouTube channel, it was based on the premise of nutrient density. It had nothing to do with the carnivore diet. Then you guys came along and then some people suggested I make anti-vegan videos and I played my cards right. Thankfully, my channel has been growing and growing and growing. So I did feel the need to address this vegan gains video today, but I did want to leave that little message at the beginning of this video so you guys understand why I'm here, so to speak. You know, I did a video on water 2.5 weeks ago, and I haven't seen a more educational video on water on YouTube, and it didn't do so well. So, you know, I'm focusing on popularity, money, income, things like that in the meantime, while trickling in some education here and there. But onto the news today, Vegan Gains' channel has been terminated. As much as I like to believe karma is real, there are people that have done far worse things without suffering, and then there are people that have done little to nothing wrong, and they have suffered far more than Vegan Gains. Whether or not he deserved this is not a decision for any of us to make. It's an unfortunate consequence of his actions. If you start slinging shit at hundreds of people, don't expect anyone to not throw it back, and depending on how many people you throw it at, you might get buried. Saying that Vegan Gains has had a questionable past is putting it nicely. He filmed his grandfather suffering from heart disease in order to say, oh, it was meat. And he has spoken out negatively against Furious Pete, a very popular YouTuber, on many occasions claiming that the cause of his reoccurring cancer is because of his meat consumption. Vegan Gains is not a genuine person. He has no integrity, no respect for himself or other people. I might make videos critiquing vegans that might be a little bit personal, but I do that for the purpose of educating people on the pitfalls of a vegan diet. When Vegan Gains does it, he would outright insult them, make them look bad, and discredit them. The main thing that bothers me is his willingness to lie and deceive people for his own benefit. In the debate he had with me, all he cared about was how intelligent he looked, making the carnivore diet look bad, making me look stupid. It wasn't about educating people. It wasn't about looking at data. It wasn't about having an honest conversation. I'm a very understanding person, and I expect some negativity from being exposed to all the vegans on his channel, but the comments on my video from the people he sent were horrendous. It's like he sent an army of vegan broccoli spear warriors to trash talk me and try to discredit me from making future videos. And these people are still commenting on my videos every day. Someone today just called me a sissy, which I think is hysterical, but some people call me very derogatory terms, from tranny to homosexual. I've even had some people say I'm an Italian N-word. Although I got some negativity before this debate, this is on a whole different level. Don't get me wrong. I have no problem taking criticism or insults when I dish them out myself, especially, but I had no clue the negativity this would bring. In hindsight, I might have prepared for the debate better, went about things a bit more seriously, but overall I'm fairly happy with how my YouTube channel has been going the past few months. It's one thing for me to critique vegans that are lying and deceiving people into the vegan cult. It's another thing for vegan gains to lie, manipulate people, attempting to discredit them, and affecting their overall livelihood by tarnishing their reputation. There's a big difference between me doing a critique of a vegan day of eating and showing concern about a child versus him just trying to make someone look stupid and whatever it may be. All of that being said, I would never wish this upon anyone. As someone who has worked very, very hard in my life, I've literally been on hundreds and hundreds of job interviews. And that's not applications, hundreds of interviews. I know how difficult life can be. I know how hard it is to make a living, and I would hate to be in his position. I mean, if I had to, I would step up to the plate and deal with it, maybe get back into bartending, pursue acting a bit more seriously. I don't really know a lot about his past videos, and I can't really speculate on why his channel was taken down, but as I said earlier with the shit-slinging analogy, if you step up to the plate enough times, you're eventually going to get hit by a pitch. Most of the time, you can walk it off, but there are some horror stories. The question is, though, if he successfully appealed the termination, how would he actually go about his channel differently? Whether he knows what resulted in his channel being removed in the first place would be a consideration, and it seems like a lot of what he does is fueled by negativity, so I don't really know if he could branch out of that and be successful, but who knows. This is interesting to me because although there are a lot of other vegan channels pushing nonsense, not a lot of them care about the carnivore diet, and they certainly aren't attacking as many people as Vegan Gains is. I was looking forward to the possible debate that was going to happen between Bart K and Vegan Gains, but this seemed to have put a big wrench in the cogwheel of all this vegan versus carnivore drama. I wonder if anyone is going to step up and take his place in this regard. I would like to think that Vegan Gains is intelligent enough to understand that certain animal nutrients are necessary for optimal human health. It's just that he's already taken his position and he's really at a point of no return in regards to his commitment to veganism. Other vegans are literally brainwashed and their knowledge of nutrition compared to someone like Vegan Gains is abysmal. Although I wouldn't say Vegan Gains is a biochemist or is honest with his understanding of nutrition, he has that moral and ethical aspect of a vegan diet holding him back. You know, he has a subjective opinion of nutrition. Me, as much as you guys don't want to believe, I have an objective opinion on nutrition in that we should be following indigenous diets. I have nothing against plant foods, although there are problems with modern plant foods. We know that these animal foods have to be present in the diet in order to have optimal health. But when you look at the general education level of most vegans, they just parrot and regurgitate information. You know, Vegan Gains at least did a little bit of Googling to back up what he was saying. You know, he might have lied and manipulated and deceived people, but compared to what other vegans are doing, they're essentially doing the same thing, except they don't understand as much about it as he does. He's able to do it in a way where he appeals to people that have a slightly higher IQ, and then if your IQ is actually high enough, you would never actually do a vegan diet. But all of that being said, thank you guys for watching. If you guys would like to support the channel, please subscribe and share the video. You know, with that message earlier, one thing I want you guys to keep in mind is anything that you guys do to support me, whether it's sharing a video, leaving a comment, giving me some advice on something, you know, all of this really does help me reach my goal. And I do sincerely appreciate, you know, all of you guys who comment, who leave questions, who do all of these things, as it's really helped me progress my knowledge and further myself in these few years that I've been on YouTube. If you guys do want to check out my Patreon, I'm doing exclusive videos now. I might share how to raise your testosterone on there after I get some blood work. I updated my Amazon shop, removed a couple things I didn't want on there. So if you guys want to buy some salt or see what products I use every day, check out my Amazon shop. I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, a lot of great information on my Twitter, Instagram, just selfies of me. And if you guys do want to reach out to me for one-on-one consultations with Frankie Boy, you can shoot me an email, frankatofano@gmail.com, or contact me through the form on my website, frank-stefano.com. Oh, if you want to look like Slick Rick, I'm selling my hair pomade. It's going to be launched next Saturday. You can pre-order the hair pomade with one of the product packages on my website, frank-stefano.com. Hopefully, I'll be able to sell it separately in the future. But in the meantime, you want to look like Slick Rick, check it out on my website. But again, thank you guys for watching, and enjoy the rest of your day.